It's the Playhouse Podcast with Kat and JJ.
Believe it. I missed everything.
Missed the show.
What am I going to do?
Check out the Daily Podcast.
Had Psychic Kim on the show this morning, and that's always a lot of fun. So many relationship questions. And then the highlight was basically when she told somebody their life was never going to get better. If you missed it, you're going to want to catch up with it in the podcast. It's coming up a little bit later on. Here we go. I read yesterday, and it made me pause. But do you know that if you're a lady in Iceland, the slang term for your lady part is the G?
Really?
They just call it the G.
Even OBGYNs call it the G?
Well, they'll probably call it the clinical term.
Okay.
But if you're just if you were just talking about it with one of your girlfriends,
yeah,
and being like, I had some problems down there with the G.
Mm-hmm.
They just call it the G.
I mean, I like that because it's not vulgar. You know, you just say
there.
The G.
It's there.
But it doesn't, it's not jarring. Like if somebody were to say, I can't say
it's
any
like if
of
you
these.
Go to Europe and if you go to England and use the word shag out loud, people are just, they turn.
Yes.
It's like, yeah, you're not supposed to say that. It's like a very, very derogatory thing. So I thought this would be interesting. What do you call it, Kat?
The tumbleweed. Go
in your mind
where you will. Tina says my grandson calls it his winky. Juliana says my son is two and he can't say it correctly, but I know he's trying to say it, but it's peanut.
Peanut, right.
Crystal says snapper. The funny joke. Her cousin came up with.
Nope. Wasn't your cousin. Nope. Wasn't her.
I don't know.
I've always referred to mine as Wally.
You have?
Wally.
Wally the Walrus? Wally.
Not, just Wally.
Polly Walnuts?
Just Wally.
Okay.
So my question is, do you have an entertaining nickname for that?
Okay. Guys and girls.
It's the G in some portions of our world. Here, I think Americans are probably the worst at coming up with a whole bunch of really slangy terms for us.
Yeah.
And I can't imagine if you are a medical professional and somebody uses one of those. I bet you've heard them all. I bet
the
you
one
nothing
that
shocks
rhymes
you
with
anymore.
Scooter, I don't like that one. That one I don't enjoy. They're just the ones that we've come up with in the U.S. are just gross.
Genesis, this isn't you. This is your man, right?
My husband, actually, which I don't mind at all. He has a nickname for his.
Mm-hmm.
He calls it Prospector.
What did prospectors do back in the day?
Well, they hunt for gold. So
yep.
he's mining for something, right?
Oh my God. It's like How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. Didn't he call it Crawl the Warrior King?
I don't remember that. But,
yeah.
And has this been like constant through your relationship or is this a new nickname?
No, this was, it's something he came up with recently. And we both liked it, so it's caught on. We've had a few other nicknames.
Yeah,
I can only imagine. I do like Prospector's the most unique so far, so thank you. I read yesterday that if you find yourself in Iceland, heads up, you know what they call the lady private part in Iceland?
So I was bracing myself, but it's not bad.
The G.
Yeah, it is what it is. Some people have dirty names, dirty minds that are texting in. I'm literally not going to say the last five.
There's some very, very interesting ones. And I want to get yours. Good morning. What's your name?
Hi, my name is Sarah.
Sarah. Well, first off, Sarah with an A or Sarah with an H?
Sarah with an H.
Sarah with an H. Then you, of course, get the...
Yeah, hello, my name is Sarah.
Sarah, what do you call it?
My son, who is now 17, used to call it his biscuits.
His what? Biscuits?
His circuits.
His circuits.
You know, like a circuit panel or something.
Okay.
Yep.
Now, is this something you continually bring up no matter how old he gets?
Yep.
Circuits.
Yep, he just laughs and smiles about it, but yeah, I don't know where he came up with it, but all of a sudden it was like one day, he was probably like 4 or 5, and he's like, oh, I got it in the circuit. And it just kind of continued on from there.
Trying to say something else? Or he was like...
No, because it carried in until he, I mean, even like 10, 11, 12 or whatever. And
yeah. Then, okay.
So, but we do bring it up. Yep.
I would never let that
It'll
rest.
Stick with him forever.
You're the best. Nice. Thanks, Sarah. We appreciate you. Good morning, Matt. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you doing?
Good. You got a nickname?
No, my 3-year-old does, though.
Yeah, okay. Like what?
My 3-year-old daughter, she calls her lady bits her dupa.
Dupa, like D-U-P-A?
Yeah, Dupa.
Okay, where did this come from?
I have no idea where she came up with it. That's what she started calling it one day, taking bath. Right.
But listen, that's a good one because she can really say it anywhere. Like you say that in church and nobody's going to turn their head, right? Like it's a good incognito kind of word.
Exactly. It doesn't seem too bad.
Right, it's very ladylike of her.
I don't get shocked by much, but some of these texts that are coming in have me like clutching my pearls. I'm like, my God, like Vlad the Impaler.
Oh, you did read it. Okay, I was going to leave Carrie's out.
Or right. How about the guy that calls it Bo Jackson?
Yeah. What about the cavemaster?
Thanks, Matt. I appreciate you. The cavemaster is a good one. There's a couple other ones out there. I got time for one more. How's Josh today?
Good, how are you?
Good, man. Nickname for it?
Mr. Happy.
Mr. Happy.
Is that the case? Is he always happy?
Every morning.
Okay. Last night I won a bingo again.
Yeah, you did mention.
I know it's not a skill to win a bingo, but man, I really feel blessed. I win almost every week.
Well, you got to be on it. You have 3 cards in front of you. If you miss a number, you're that guy.
It does move pretty slow.
What was that? So... what are some faux pas? Because I don't play bingo often. So obviously yelling bingo when you don't got it.
Yeah, that's a big one.
That's a big one. And then anything else?
Well, just kind of talking during the... And then if you order your... Like people, they have waitresses come around if you want a drink or some food or something like that. And if you say that really loud while they're calling a number.
Yeah.
Yeah, people get a little bit irritated by you. I think there's also some spacing at tables. Like every once in a while, there'll be like a group of 4, a group of 6. Mm-hmm. Don't go sit right next to them. You got to give like a chair gap because they got their own special vibe. But I have noticed, and I'm going to, I forgot last night, but a lot of people bring like lucky trinkets with them.
Yeah. And like so, in that Roseanne episode with the trolls.
Yeah. There's some trolls. Yeah. There's a couple of people that have trolls. One guy has, it looks like a rock, but it's painted. And I think it says like Papa or Grandpa on it or something.
Oh, that's cute.
So I think he got like a painted rock from one of his grandchildren. And so I'm like, all right, what do I bring? And so I'm really starting to think about what I can bring for a lucky troll, kind of like a lucky
You're not going to get one of those like wristbands with the pad right here. So
I don't get the ink on my hands. Yeah. No, but my wife is a heavy dauber. She goes,
oh, no.
She's a heavy dauber, like to the point where it bleeds through to the next one. I go, Trish, you just got to touch it with that thing. You know what I mean? So we might have to invest in maybe like a lighter flow dauber for her. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I won a bingo again last night. And I usually don't have much to brag about in my life. Because
20 bucks is 20 bucks.
Nothing really good ever happens to me, but I did win. So riding that high. I had mentioned what I found for your Christmas present. I'm going to divulge that in a second because
You're
I think
tell me?
You are going to freak out. But first.
I don't want it now.
I don't have it now. It's on order.
Okay.
But I want you to know about it so you can prepare. This will be a life adjustment that you'll need to make.
It
wouldn't hurt, but hang tight for that.
All
right. Coachella has announced the lineup for 2025. If you plan on making the journey, you will see Post Malone, Green Day, Travis Scott, and headlining Lady Gaga.
Love that. Not even mad.
She's
so incredible.
A healthy lineup.
Still in Palm Springs, which I found out my cousins, Ricky and Brian, their parents have 2 timeshares there.
So I'm sure that's going to go for a healthy amount.
Yeah, probably.
That's a great deal. Now, what are we getting Kat for Christmas? For, I don't know, 45 weeks a year, I struggle thinking, what can I get for the lady who has everything.
Right.
Well, I found it. It's on order. And it will be a game changer for your life.
Mm-hmm.
I was unaware that you could even get this on the internet. And then I was told about it, and I did some research this morning. And soon to be under your tree, at home, wrapped delicately but seasonably.
Get to it!
Will be a gallon jug of McRib sauce.
You lie.
They sell.
You lie.
Gallon jugs of McRib. Now, the McRib is coming back to McDonald's, and I know you have it on your calendar on December 3rd. But I have found an outlet. I know a guy who knows a guy who knows a clown who knows a guy who
get
works at McDonald's.
Get your money back. Do not get me a gallon jug of
you
barbecue sauce.
Gallon jug. It's not barbecue sauce.
McRib
it's
is barbecue.
No, it's McRib sauce. Now, I know you like to put it in your coffee and you like to smear it on toast. And sometimes you'll just eat it with a like your hand and then just.
Why wouldn't you just get me like a bunch of McRibs? Now you're having me work for my meal.
Because sometimes you don't want the whole McRib.
Yes,
you, you just want a taste of McRib sauce. But you can buy this year.
Refund.
You say that now. But when December 26th rolls around and you've drank just straight up in a shot glass most of your McRib sauce, I could see you walking by and be like, Derek, sauce.
And sauce me.
And then he slides it down the center island like a bar.
Like catch it before it hits the edge.
And then you catch it, boom, shoot it back, and the day just gets better. A shot of McRib sauce.
I love where your heart's at. Once but my gift for you is so thoughtful, it's ridiculous.
Well,
I've never been. It's not thoughtful because you are a saboteur.
I'm not.
You know that all I do is all I do is try to watch what goes in my body. You think that's going
to
do anything good for my body?
Eat it all at once. That's up to you.
Of course, I'll have to eat it all at once.
If you have no self control over your McRib sauce, then that's on you. But how great!
Well,
would this
thank you.
You're
so excited.
It's on its way. Friday morning, it's going to be a huge show. Johnny D will be here mixing up old school for us. Well, one last chance for you to get on the party plane to Paradise to Punta Cana. And then at 8:20, we've got one more pair of tickets to Post Malone and Jelly Roll before we hit the weekend. So lots to be here for during the live show. Right now, let's wrap up the podcast.
I'm amazing. How are you?
Great. I love that answer. What's your question for Kim? Are you in a new relationship or is this an established thing?
We've been together for 6 months.
Okay.
And I was just wondering, I feel like he's the one. I was just wondering if he is.
Ooh, is this like long-term, maybe marriage, Kim?
Yeah, it feels calm.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm liking this. Yeah,
great.
Keep going. Yes, keep going.
What's the best thing?
It feels very good.
What's the best thing about him, Rochelle?
The relationship is really easy. I've never had a relationship that's so easy. He's kind. He's caring. He's everything. He loves my kids.
Then why would you be calling right now? Because that sounds like a no-brainer.
It's validation.
Yeah, validation.
Okay.
Well, onward, upward.
I've had lots of bad relationships in the past.
I think it'll all... are you hoping for a ring for the holidays?
Well, I think maybe my birthday. I think holidays is too soon.
Okay. All right. We'll stick with it.
My birthday's in February.
Sounds like this is the guy.
Thank you.
Yeah. Have a great morning. Let's move on to Stacy. How's Stacy today?
I'm good. How are you?
Really good. Thanks for asking. You got Psychic Kim. What would you like to ask about? Yours is a relationship question, too, right?
Yes. I just really want to know, do we have a future? Are we going to stay together?
All right. Kind of same question, but different person. What are you thinking here?
Yep. I see a little bit of rocks, and I see a little bit of up and down. So there's some things that kinks that need to be worked out for it to be very long term. Nothing that's major or bad or anything like that. It's just more I hear indifferences, maybe belief systems. But they're like once you get through that, yes, smooth sailing.
Does that make sense, Stacey? You guys got a couple of hang-ups that maybe, you know, you weren't necessarily brought up the same way that are... Yeah, all right. Well, good. I mean, apparently you get over this, and it's clear sailing.
Yep. Awesome. I'd love to hear that.
It's a good start to the morning. Have a great day, Stacey. I appreciate you checking in. Lindsay's here as well. Good morning, Lindsay. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you.
Good. We're great, too. Thanks for asking. Congrats on the new job, and your question has to do with that, right?
Yeah. Yep. So I just started at a brand new position, and I normally like to state my places of business for quite a long time, and so I just wanted to see how this one was going to go, and was everything going to work out and pan out. So,
yes, I actually want to like almost 10 hut in front of you, like you're my boss in front of me. I'm like, okay, what do you need me to do? So you must be in more of a management or boss type role, because I could feel that off of you right away. You definitely have a great way of working with people, hearing people, talking to them. I hear you're an outside of the box thinker. And then I see a lot of clapping. Yes. Like you're, and then I hear moving on up. So
Oh my gosh, that's so nice.
You're right there. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's like spot on. I appreciate that. How cool.
You're like Wheezy Jefferson.
Yep. Yeah. I'm sorry, I don't know who that is.
That's, oh, God.
Because he's 90. He does these references.
You young people are driving me crazy. All right, well, you're going to be fine. And then what you have to do is today, spend some time at your new job and just YouTube the Jeffersons.
Okay. All right. I will. Okay. I'll totally take a moment
to do
that.
All right.
Please do. It's great. Have a great morning. We appreciate it. I got time for one more this round. If you guys want to call and get in line for next round, absolutely holler at us. Kendra, good morning. How are you?
Good. I'm doing good. How are you guys?
Great. Thank you for asking. What, do you got a bunch of boys in your family right now? Why are you asking about a girl?
I have six boys.
Holy crap.
Including five boys. Sorry. I have five boys, including two fraternal twins.
Oh, my goodness. You have your hands full. So I assume I know what question you're going to ask Psychic Kim. Go ahead.
Is there a girl in my future?
My first thought is no.
Oh.
But you're going to have lots of amazing daughters in your life in the future. Just may not be from your womb, is kind of how I'm getting it.
So daughter-in-laws, and then maybe granddaughters, which would be even better. Because then you can just give them back when you're done.
Kendra, are you one of those silly parents that named all your boys the names that all started with the same letter?
No, that drives me nuts. My brother did that, though. He has five kids as well.
Wow. Did you come from a big family?
Nope. There's just three of us siblings.
Interesting.
Jeez.
And you want to do another.
You're like a Pez dispenser.
Crazy. Oh, that's enough.
It's Tima, right? Team.
No?
This thing keeps Tima, good morning. You're still there, right?
Yes, okay. I'm here. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
Oh, we're great. Thank you so much for asking. That's so rare these days. So we talked a little bit off the air, and you're basically kind of in a spot where you're hoping to be a homeowner eventually here, but you're not sure that this is going to happen, right?
Yeah, because I just moved from here, from Delaware here, 3 months ago.
Yeah.
And I got three kids and divorced mother, too. And I'm really scared to get out there. I've been divorced.
Okay, so you need a home, you need a safe place for the whole family. What does home ownership look like for her, Kim?
I do see a smaller type home coming in her future, but it's going to be definitely not till next year sometime. I keep getting smaller apartments, so I'm not sure if you're in a smaller apartment right now, but I feel like I'm kind of cramped and we're all like... right on top of each other. And then I see you working with different banks and stuff like that, and it's a headache. I'm telling you, like, I hear people are not hearing you. They're not listening to you and what you need. So I'm so sorry that that's happening to you, and I want to cry.
Oh.
So they're like, keep working at it. You're a very strong, very independent woman. Wow. And they're like, watch out. When she says she's going to do something, she's going to do it too. And So you are going to get a home. It's going to be a little finagling of stuff around, but you definitely are going to get a home, and it probably won't be till more next year sometime. I'm getting pulled into like summerish type air type. Yeah.
So get through the winter and you're good to go.
Yeah. There's some ups and downs that she's got to get through.
Hey, Tima, my question is, what brings you here from Delaware?
Well, I got divorced. I got three kids, and my brother he took me in.
Catch.
He got 5 bedrooms. He was saying, okay, you can stay here after 2 years, then you can get out, get your house, and he gave me a job, too, so bless his heart.
Oh, that's so generous.
Like a great situation. So get through the winter, and looks like things will be looking up, all right?
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Have a great morning. Hey, Kim, do you feel bad about telling people that their relationships are never going to work out?
No, because it's not coming from me. I'm blaming on spirit.
Yep. You're just being honest. I people don't call to hear you lie to them. They want to know the honest
truth.
Listen,
if I called here and she told me I'm never going to find someone again, I would be pissed.
But it's also, she also likes to put the emphasis on the fact that you can change your fate. Like,
yes.
You can get out there and do different things than you're doing right now, because right now it's not working. So.
And sometimes you need time for yourself. Doesn't mean that she's going to be not with anybody her entire life. It's just right now she needs to focus on her, not on trying to fix somebody else.
It's a unique opportunity right now for an average, everyday American like Matt to dethrone the queen of radio, rock, paper, scissors.
Let's become
a new champion. Matt, is there anything in your life that's ever, you know, you've won an award, or maybe you were like all conference in basketball. Is there anything that would stand up to being a radio, rock, paper, scissors champion?
I was first chair trumpet in high school.
Oh, okay. So he played the trumpet in high school. He was first chair. I mean, obviously, something like that prepares you for the intense pressure that you're about to be under. So it's radio, rock, paper, scissors. We've all played this. Kat's become the world champion because, well, it's her biggest skill set.
And be mature. Don't throw dynamite. It's rock, paper, or scissors.
Yeah, all right. So basically what I'm going to do is I'll just say 1, 2, 3, shoot. And then you throw, Kat will throw. And if you can win 2 out of 3, then that being first chair, trumpet in high school will like not even compare to what's about to happen to you.
It's pretty big.
Be living the rock star lifestyle.
Here we
he
go.
Is. All right. 1, 2, 3, shoot.
Paper.
Rock.
What a jump.
All right. Matt. You don't have to call names. Okay.
All right.
Matt, if you just, because you've got a phone delay, if you just wait a second, you'll hear what she says first, you know. All right. Round number two. 1, 2, 3, shoot.
Rock.
Paper.
Hey, look at this guy. Look at this guy. The comeback.
I don't know how you turn this around.
This is that pressure from playing trumpet.
We're heating up.
All right.
Last one for the dub, Matt. 1, 2, 3, shoot.
Rock.
Paper.
Oh my God, we got a winner.
I tried to trick you.
You'll be able to put this on your Christmas card, and everybody will now shower you with blessings because you were able to figure out the world's easiest radio contest. As Kat watches the DNR Eagle Cam and doesn't pay attention to your day.
I'm here.
I'm here thinking about your final hours on the planet. And as you fade into another plane, your time here on Earth is done. Family members mourn your loss. They remember the great times you provided them here in this life. And you think, you kind of feel yourself elevate. And all of a sudden you're standing at the pearly gates and there's St. Peter.
Is that who decides?
Yeah.
Who says who?
The Bible.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not dead. I'm not supposed to tell you. But let's just say you get there and St. Peter says, no. Wrong spot, jackass. You didn't do it right. And you're sentenced to a lifetime in the burning chaos of hell. What TV show is playing on repeat that would prove to you that you are in eternal damnation, Kat?
You're going to hate this answer, but I just hate this show. Pawn Stars. It's the worst.
Why do I hate that answer? Because everyone says I look like that guy.
Oh, I thought you enjoyed it. I thought you liked the show.
I do like the show.
I hate it.
Why?
So much. And I don't like the Suns. They're just gross and grubby and weird. And like, it's the same spiel every single time, you know, and then they try to talk them down. And these are one of a kind.
Let me call an expert.
Yeah. Like, this is the first pair of Dolly Parton underwear that she ever wore on stage.
And then so like, if you die and you see Pawn Stars is on repeat over and over again on the television, the only television you can watch in the next part of your existence, they know you're in hell.
If I had to pick, so that was my TV. If I had to pick a movie, it would be Dances with Wolves. Derek loves that movie. And I just can't.
It's like 7.5 hours long.
I don't enjoy it at all.
What would be the one television show that would prove that you were in hell? Andy, we'll start with you.
Probably Seinfeld.
No!
Hush your mouth.
No. I'm going a heavy no on that. That means you're in heaven, I think.
Even the beginning episodes of their journey into the Seinfeld stardom, I even enjoy those.
I'll watch Seinfeld on the stair stepper or the treadmill.
I love it.
Because it gets me through 22 minutes so fast. Jennifer, the television show or movie that you would see that would prove that you were in hell?
I would say Star Trek.
Star Trek. I think that'll be a kind of a popular answer. I got time for a couple more here real quick. Bob!
That would probably be like Leave it to Beaver. Oh my God, I hated that show when I was a kid.
Leave it to Beaver, so innocent.
It just doesn't transcend anymore. There are certain shows that you watched back in the day. Like if I were to sit down and watch Saved by the Bell now, I'd probably be a bit bored.
It's
back
super
in the
cheesy.
Day, though, I'm like, oh my God, they're like living my life.
When you're a kid, you don't see the intricacies of how bad it really is. Amy, I got time for one more. You know you're in hell if what's on TV on repeat.
Modern Family.
What?
Wow.
I'm vetoing that one as well.
I'm trying to wrap my mind around what you would not like about that show.
Phil Dunphy is hilarious.
What about Cam? Cam's the best.
I have a good reason.
Okay.
I was confined somewhere for 30 days, and that's all that played.
Oh. They played?
I got a lot of questions about this, but...
Was it like a torture thing, or was it...
How? I don't know.
She was a POW, and they played it over and over again. And
exactly.
That was...
That's about it. Yeah.
Okay, now, what's the worst part about Modern Family?
Her voice. Sofia Vergara's voice.
Oh, my God. That's
all I hear.
JJ says she could read the Bible, and he would just be the happiest man on earth.
She could read the Bible in pig Latin, and I'd be okay with that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but if you had to hear it when you were going to the bathroom, when you were eating, when you were sleeping, no, you wouldn't.
You hear it in your nightmares, huh?
You're just jaded by Modern Family, huh?
You know what I think? I think she's faking it a little bit. I don't think it's that strong. I think she gets home and she's like, oh my God, these people just drive me crazy.
She slips into her heavy Latin dialect.
Right.
Right.
Well, I can understand where you're coming from. I can't agree, but I can understand. So I hope you have a great morning.
Get out with LPP. Can you help me? Get out with LPP. Can you help me?
People's problems. That's what OPP is all about. Bring it to the radio. Let's see what everybody has to say about this. And Lon, we know we got some money issues here, huh? You want to tell us about it?
Yeah, man. Well, I ended up letting my daughter borrow $2,000 for this new car that she wanted.
Okay.
And I told her, hey, you know, keep the money and just hold on to it for 90 days. You know, take time, get yourself together, figure things out, you know, and pay me back. So my wife goes back and tells my daughter that she doesn't have to pay me back at all, that everything is all good, it's all taken care of.
Why would she do that?
I have no clue. That's the same thing that I'm wondering myself. That this was supposed to be a way to teach my daughter how to be responsible, you know? And she just threw it all out the window. And on top of it, they've lied to me, you know? She told me that the money was good, that it was placed back, but my daughter doesn't. My daughter thinks that she's good. And so at this point, my wife is just basically, I guess, playing.
She just gifted her that money. I mean, if she doesn't have to pay it back, it's a gift then, right?
Not for me.
Yeah. So you wanted it to be a gift with a lesson, which I understand. But then your wife went behind your back and like was like, oh, no, Lon, we put the money into our account. She paid us back. We're all good to go.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah, this has happened at my house more than once where I've been like trying to teach the kids a lesson. Hey, I'm going to borrow you $50. I need this back Friday or the juice starts running.
Yeah.
And then my wife will be like, oh, no, he paid me back. I'd be like, really? And I'll circle back and I'd be like, did you pay that back? Well, no, Mom said I didn't have to. And, listen, all I can tell you from my angle is my dad said a long time ago, know which fight to put your dog in, and I don't fight about money with my wife. But I get where you're coming from, man. You feel slighted here, huh?
Yeah, exactly. It's like, you know, at least if you were going to tell her that, let me know so that I'm in on it. I'm not sitting here thinking that I'm being the parent who's teaching my daughter right, and sure, all along she's not learning anything.
Let's do this, and I appreciate your call. I'm going to put you on hold here for a second, but how would you handle this if Liam borrowed $100 for whatever from you and you said you got to pay it back in 60 days?
Yeah.
And then Derek just said, no, don't even worry about it. How would you handle that?
We'll pretend. You know, I don't like that aspect of parenting. Like, everybody should be on the same page. I would love to hear from people that have had this happen where they're trying to parent and then the other one kind of goes behind the other one's back. Or the worst is when you say something that is opposite of what the other parent is saying in front of the kids. I mean, talk about, like, sabotage.
I can't prove it, but I'm pretty sure my wife did this with my daughter's freshman year tuition, where she had gotten a lot of scholarships, so she wasn't going to pay, you know, full tuition. But and she paid a lot of it, you know, by working, but I'm pretty sure there was some leftovers. And then my wife was like, oh, you made the dean's list. You're okay. We're going to just eat that. And I'm, like I said, I can't prove it because I don't know, but I'm pretty sure that happened.
How much would that have been?
I think it was $6,000 or $7,000.
You know, if I had the coin and my kid was holding up his end of the bargain and being, and
but that wasn't the agreement.
List,
that wasn't the agreement. When
I know,
we started.
I know.
The agreement was you pay your tuition.
Yeah.
I want to know if you've been through something like this and how would you handle it if you were launched?